afternoon. Good afternoon. Let's stand together. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. One more time. We'll go tell it on the mountain, over the hill and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching by night, behold, throughout the heaven there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in a lowly manger the humble Christ was born, and brought us God's salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Well, go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. That Jesus Christ is born. Can you just give the Lord a clap offering? Hallelujah. Look to a neighbor and say, I'm glad you're here today. And you may be seated. God bless you. Thank you for taking your time and coming and worshiping with us on this great Christmas season, our Christmas Shoes drama presentation. We couldn't be more delighted that you've taken your afternoon to be here with us online and in the house of the Lord. God bless you and thank you so very much. We're delighted again that you have chosen to be with us. May the Lord richly bless you for doing that. It's gonna get a little dark in here. As you notice, we have covered the windows, and so be careful if you're coming and going during the presentation, because it's gonna get a little dark. I do have to share a little information with you concerning one of our loved ones. We had a widow lady that went home to be with the Lord on Wednesday. Ida Baldwin passed away during a routine surgery. It was a surgery, pre-surgery kind of deal. And she went home to be with the Lord, Ida Baldwin. So please be in prayer for the family, the Baldwin family and the Easton family. As I said, she was a member here, so please be in prayer for them. My Bible says, precious in the sight of the Lord are the death of his saints. And she was a dear saint. She was a dear lady. And listen, that's why we're celebrating today. This is why we're here worshiping the Lord. I don't know if you know this or not, but we're just passing through this life. Got one amen. We're just passing through this life. I know, we just ate and you're like, I said, we just passing through this life. And if you know Jesus as your personal Savior, we're heaven bound. So she is there now, absent from the body and present with the Lord. Hallelujah. We do not know the details of the funeral, so just watch our bulletin and calendar, and we will inform you just as soon as we know those details. By the way, nursery is open. 0 to 3 years of age. In the foyer, we have a couple of different rooms for that. So just make note of that. I got to do the normal announcements because it's the Christmas season and just got to make those announcements. Kids church this week was canceled and it's canceled next week on Christmas Day. We're just going to have the family outing. We have a special weekend planned. Wednesday night, however, see, I'm keeping you popcorned. I'm going to make you stay with me. Wednesday night is normal service until the 28th. There is no Wednesday night service next week, but this coming week, this week that we're in, everything's normal, except for Christmas Eve. We have a special service at 4 p.m. We're gonna have a candlelight communion service. Pastor Craig Carter will be with us, and he's going to do the innkeeper. We did it last year, and it was a great service. So join us at 4 p.m. on Christmas Eve. Now, if you don't know, that's December 24th. Okay, just want to make sure you're tracking with me. And then Christmas Day, a 9:30 service. Again, candlelight communion. I can't get enough of that. So Christmas Day, 9:30, candlelight communion service. Our Spanish church is joining us. Pastor David is our guest speaker with an English translator. It's going to be a great service. Their worship team is joining us. So 9:30 on Christmas Day. By the way, that's December 25th. Okay, gotcha. You're still with me. And then Sunday, January 1st, we're back to normal services. And worship the Lord is also in our tithes and offerings. This is Sunday, so I trust that our members and regular attenders are ready to give to the Lord. Our ushers have an envelope if you did not get one on your way in, and we have those for you. Thank you for your generous giving throughout the year. God has blessed AJ First through our building program. We're sitting in a wonderful building that the Lord had provided, but you were obeyed the Lord in your giving. And so thank you again for your giving and tithes and offerings. If you'd raise a hand if you need an envelope, we will get those in your possession. Also, year-end giving. I don't know if you know this or not, but we're encroaching on December 31st. Pastor Bill is our CFO, and he told me if you call him, if you make arrangements, he will be here at 11:59 on December 31st. Give him a hand, yes. So year-end giving, thank you. May the Lord again richly bless you for your faithfulness to the Lord. I don't know if you know this or not, but God is good. All the time, God is good. So look at your bulletin. Next week, we'll have a full schedule of our office hours for the next couple of weeks. Why don't you stand with me one more time? We're going to sing Angels from the Realms of Glory.
Shepherds in the field abiding, watching all your flocks by night. God with man is now residing, yonder shines the infant light. Come and worship, worship Christ the newborn King. Oh, come and worship, worship Christ the newborn King. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, you are the God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, come have your way. Worship Christ, the newborn King. God is with us even now. His love is here. Come and worship, worship Christ, the newborn King. God is with us even now. His love is here. His love is here.
You just worship with us for a moment. Time. Come on, just lift up your voices. Oh, in the presence, yes, Lord, of Jehovah, He's God Almighty and the Prince of Peace. Troubles all vanish, and hearts are mended. Heavenly Father, we're so grateful that you're here this afternoon. We thank you for your goodness and your mercies. And I pray over the next few moments that we would open up our hearts and our minds and our spirits to receive from you. We give you all the glory and all the praise. And Lord, we just want to worship you through this drama presentation. We're asking you to bless and anoint every facet and everyone who has come in and joined us in the house of the Lord and everyone that's joined us online. Lord, would you minister through us and to them? Lord, here we are. We praise you, we magnify you, and we glorify you. Thank you for your presence being here in a very real way. Touch our hearts and our minds again, I ask, in Jesus' holy name. And all of God's people said, amen. Hallelujah.
How's everybody doing this afternoon? Doing great. Awesome. My name is Robert, and this is my story. One night, several years ago, when joy was far away from me, God's grace reached down and touched my life. And that grace has inspired me to share with you the things that I have learned. As you watch, you may see some similarities to your life. Let's face it. We all have questions, and it's taken me a long time to figure out what the important questions are. Not how am I going to get a raise or how am I going to get the next promotion, but instead, what are God's plans for my life? What are my wife's dreams? That one night, several years ago, I had an encounter with a young boy, and he helped me see what was really important. Now I can see how God's hand has been and guided my life. Some people, as you watch, you may look at this and go, it's just a coincidence, just two lives passing by. Back then, I would have said the exact same thing. Back then, you could not have convinced me that God would use a pair of shoes to change someone's life. But now, I believe.
Shepherds on the hillside. Mom, isn't Dad going to help us decorate the tree?
I don't think so, Lily.
Why not?
Because he has a huge stack of work and he can't leave the office till it's done.
He can never leave the office.
I think this is going to be the most beautiful Christmas tree we have ever had, kids.
What's your favorite thing about it, Mama?
I think the most favorite part this year are these popcorn strands. It makes it really easy to snack on the popcorn, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. What is your favorite part, Nathan?
My favorite thing is a snowman I made at school.
Oh.
Well, where are your snowmen, Nathan?
I don't know.
Hey, what do you think about checking in your backpack? Maybe you left it there.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
yeah.
There's a good idea.
Honey, how you holding up tonight? Are you feeling well, or are you ready to call it quits?
Oh, no. I'm actually feeling really well, honey.
Oh, good.
You know, Nathan loves to decorate the tree, and I just want to be a part of that this year with him.
Okay, yeah. Great.
Maggie, you haven't taken any of your medicine today, honey. Won't you take some now, please?
You know, Mom, this is going to be my last Christmas, and I just don't want to take the meds. I just want to be able to feel good today.
Oh, Maggie, don't be that way, honey.
Well, Mom, it's true. We know it's my last Christmas, and, you know, I don't want this Christmas to be all wrapped up in my illness. I want Nathan and Allie to enjoy Christmas. They love it. I want them always to love Christmas.
Yes, I do, too.
Here it is.
Hey.
Oh, wow. That looks like Frosty himself, yes. Doesn't it? How beautiful.
There we go.
Oh, you guys made the tree look so much better.
Well, Nathan, we can't decorate a Christmas tree without Christmas music. Will you run and turn the radio on?
Oh, yeah, good idea.
Girls have a good day?
Yep, they've been asleep for the last 2 hours.
You guys do anything exciting today?
We decorated the tree.
Looks nice.
I'm tired, Robert.
You can go to bed. You didn't have to wait it for me.
I'm tired of this. I'm tired of us. I'm tired of pretending that everything's okay. It's not okay. You only have time for one person in your life, and that's yourself. Let's face it, you left this family a long time ago. Just because we're living under the same roof doesn't mean that we're living together.
What's your point, Kate?
When we got married, we agreed that we would raise these kids in a Christ-centered home, and you don't even want to go to church anymore. We'll stay together through the holidays. I don't want to ruin Christmas for my family or for your mother, and it would devastate the girls if we separated right now. But as soon as Christmas is over, I think you need to find another place to live.
Whatever.
Come on, girls, let's go shopping.
Hey, Mom, why didn't Dad come shopping with us?
Because Daddy doesn't like to shop.
Dad doesn't like doing anything.
Oh, God. Excuse me, I'm sorry. I wasn't watching where I was going.
It's okay.
Sorry, I'm looking for the perfect gift.
For your girlfriend?
My wife. I know exactly what I want to get. I'm just having a little trouble finding it. Anyway, sorry.
It's
Merry
okay.
Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, Mom, do you think Dad's trying to find the perfect gift for you?
Doubt it.
Huh?
Let's go shopping.
Don't
the most cutest Peanuts movie we have ever seen.
It sure is, Mom.
Yeah, it was so cute. Oh, I am so tired.
Yeah.
I think Ellie and I will go to bed now.
All right.
Ellie, you want to say goodnight to Mommy and Daddy and Brother?
Good night, Ellie. Sweet dreams, sweetheart. Good night,
Good
Mama.
Night,
Good night, Princess.
Thank you for all your help today,
Love you,
Mom.
Mommy.
Good
yeah.
night, son.
Love
Good
you
night,
both.
Mom.
Good night.
Night.
Okay.
Mrs. Patterson let us watch Rudolph today since it was our last day in class.
Oh, cool.
Oh, my goodness. She thinks of the most fun things to do, doesn't she?
Uh-huh. Today she had everybody stand up and tell their favorite Christmas memory. Tyler brought a picture of Santa coming in his kitchen door, and someone hacked Joseph Snowman to death.
Oh, that sounds so awful. Oh, my goodness.
Tell me, what was your favorite Christmas memory?
My favorite Christmas memory was when my mom, dad, and me went sledding all day long at Hurley's farm. My dad fell off the back of the sled because we have too many people on it. And my mom laughed the whole way down the hill. And then we ate chicken and dumplings and drank hot chocolate, and my mom and dad danced around the Christmas tree.
I remember that.
Wow, I think that is probably my most favorite memory and funniest memory, too.
Mine, too, except I had trouble walking straight for about a week after that.
Mrs. Patterson told us her favorite Christmas memory of how her grandma gave her a special pair of red shoes. She even slept in them.
Wow, they sound so beautiful and special. My goodness.
She can tell you the whole story once you get better and you can help out in class again.
Oh, wow. Yeah, maybe so. You know, honey, I could really use some hot tea right now. Can you get me some?
Sure.
Yeah. So, Nathan, I wanted to talk to you a little bit. You know, over the next few weeks, some things are going to be going on that are going to be kind of confusing for you, honey.
You mean about school, Mama?
No, not so much about school, but you know Mama's sick, right? And when you get older, it might be really tempting to want to blame God for me being sick. But Nathan, I don't want you to blame God for making me sick. Honey, God didn't make me sick, and please remember that. God has actually helped me through my illness. You know, there have been some really great days where he's given me the energy to play and run and sing and have such an amazing time with you and your sister. But there have been some times that I've been really sick too, and God has helped me through those days.
God's gonna take you to heaven?
Yeah, kinda. You know, you're gonna hear some adults say that. You're gonna hear adults say out there that it's such a pity that God took her when she was so young. But please remember that what they're saying is not true. God's not taking me, okay? God is already up in heaven. His arms are open wide like that, and he's going to receive me in all of his love. So there's a big difference between God taking me and receiving me. So please remember that, hon, okay?
I just don't want you to leave me.
I don't want to leave you either. I'm going to miss you so much, and I'd do anything to be able to stay here with you and your sister and your daddy, but I am sick, and I'm going to be taking a journey to heaven. Do you want to know what heaven is like? Yeah. Heaven, I think, is going to be the most beautiful place ever. I don't even know the first thing that I'm going to do there, but I do think, at first, I'm just going to stare at God in all of his wonder. I'm going to thank him for sending you to me. I have an amazing son and daughter, your sister. I'm going to thank him for that. But I'm also going to thank him for sending Jesus to us at Christmas time. And you know what else? I'm not going to be sick up there. That's really good, right? I'm going to be able to dance. I'm going to sing. Woohoo! We're going to have a great time up there. I'm going to be doing great.
Will you see Grandpa there?
Yes, Grandpa's going to be there. And, you know, his arms, he's a big guy. He's going to be welcoming with his big old hug, too, right at the gates when I get to heaven. This is really hard, isn't it, sweetie? You know, I wish I didn't have to leave you guys. You know, when my daddy died, I always thought he lived in my heart. And that's what I want you to think about, is that I'm going to be living in your heart when my time is to go to heaven. And the best part about that is with Jesus, all of us someday will all be in heaven together to see each other, and we'll be with Jesus.
I just don't want you to leave me.
I'm always going to be in your heart, and I'm going to miss you so much. I can't even tell you how much I love you, baby. You know, it's a lot you've been taking in tonight. We talked a lot here. Maybe it's time to get ready for bed, okay? All right.
Yeah, why don't you run along, little buddy? I'll be along in a moment to tuck you in.
Okay. I love you, Nathan.
Love you, Mama. All right. Good night.
We'll see you in the morning, baby.
Here you go, hon.
Oh, thank you. It's perfect. Honey, I don't think he understood that.
I noticed that.
Yeah.
I'll explain it to him again and again and again until he does.
Thank you. I know you will. I love you.
I love you, honey.
Love you, too.
Do you want me to tell you the Christmas story?
Yes.
Do you really want to hear it? Or are you just trying to stay up past your bedtime?
Both. It's not Christmas without it.
All right. One silent night, 2,000 years ago, a man named Joseph and his wife Mary, who was with child, were traveling to the city of David, to the town of Bethlehem. Caesar Augustus had issued a decree that a census be taken, and every citizen had to be counted. So Joseph led a weary Mary into Bethlehem, but no one seemed to notice them. No one seemed to care that she was carrying God's holy son, the Savior of our world.
There were no palaces or crowns, majestic robes or gowns, waiting for the coming of the King. They were looking for a sign, hope in desperate times, a miracle that only God could bring. Savior here on earth, could it be that Bethlehem beheld the chosen birth? As the world slept one silent night, a Savior's born and all creation smiles. As the world slept heaven's child, oh, could it really be that Mary did conceive and bear the Holy One, God's only Son? As the world slept, while shepherds watched their flocks by night, behold, an angel from on high proclaimed to them the Prince of Peace had come. A star of wonder led the way to the stable where he lay, the gift of love from God to everyone. While many still were praying for a king, heaven's answer was in this baby's birth. As the world slept one silent night, a Savior's born and all creation smiles. As the world slept one holy night, and to a man low crept heaven's child. Oh, could it really be that Mary but heaven's child. As the world slept one holy night, into a manger low crept heaven's child. Oh, could it really be that Mary did conceive and bear the Holy One, God's only Son?
Seriously? I can't believe this. My word.
Mr. Layton, if it's all right, I'd like to go home now. You know, my husband's at home alone cooking dinner for the family. We're expecting his parents to show up any moment now.
Gwen.
Well, it's Christmas Eve. I wasn't expecting to be here this late. And if my husband was a better cook, I probably would stay later.
Gwen, just go home. It's fine.
You sure? Mr.
Yeah.
Layton, are you ready for Christmas?
Gwen, I don't feel I have the need to talk about Christmas, okay? You don't have to make small talk with me. Just go home. I'm fine.
Okay.
Seriously. Mark? Mark?
Yes, Mr. Layton.
Where are the Reynolds files?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I've already locked away all the files. My wife's going to kill me. We're supposed to get off at 3 today.
Fine.
Do you want me to go look for them anyways?
No. I will take care of it myself. Like I have to do everything around here.
Well, why don't you go home soon? I mean, it's already 7 o'clock.
Mark, as soon as I'm done with my work, I'm not like everybody else. I don't get the privilege of going home and doing whatever I want. As soon as I'm done with my work, I'll go home.
But, okay. I mean, it's Christmas Eve, and, you know, the shops are going to close soon, and...
Like I said, Mark, when I'm finished with my work, I'll go home.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, too.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel.
You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch.
You're a banana with a
greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole.
Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul,
Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole.
Oh, no.
Soul is full of gunk, Mr. Grinch.
The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote,
stink,
stink,
stink, stunk. You nauseate me, Mr. Grinch, with the nauseous super nauseous. Crooked jerky jockey, and you drive a crooked boss, Mr. Grinch.
You're a triple-decker sauerkraut and toadstool sandwich
with arsenic sauce. You're a mean one, Mr.
Gwen? Gwen? Oh, that's right. I let her go home early. 7:30. I better get going. There's no stores that are going to be open now. Christmas Eve, I got to get going. Seriously.
Thank you.
nice. What about something like this for mom, for mother's? Hey, kid, watch it.
Sorry, sir.
Seriously, where are the parents at around here? About something like this, I'm not going to buy this for Kate. It's too expensive. I'm not bribing her to stay. Even though she tells her friends I'm going to bribe her to stay. Like, seriously. My word. This is kind of nice. But, kid! Hey! What's up, dude?
$39.95.
Get this. Get this. This is kind of nice.
Thank you. Have a nice
day. I'm buying these shoes for my mom. They're just her size.
Well, that's pretty nice. I'm glad you're doing that.
$62.50, please. Oops. Thank you. Have a nice Christmas.
Thank you.
These are nice.
Kind of matches.
$24.75, please. Son, you don't have enough money. Maybe you can run home and ask your mom and dad for some more money.
But can't I bring you the rest of the money tomorrow?
I'm sorry, honey. We're closed.
But my dad says that there's not much time and Mama might leave to see Jesus.
What?
I said my mom's been dreaming of dancing in these special pair of red shoes, and I knew these were the perfect ones. I want her to look so beautiful, and I just want her to have the best Christmas ever.
Here, let me cover the rest.
Here.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome, son. Merry Christmas to you. Everything's going to be okay. Okay?
Okay.
It'll be okay.
Thank you.
You.
Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Yes!
It was almost Christmas time. There I stood in another line, trying to buy the last gift or two, not really in the Christmas mood. And standing right in front of me was a little boy waiting anxiously, pacing round like little boys do, and in his hand he held a pair of shoes. And his clothes were worn and old, he was dirty from head to toe. And when it came his time to pay, I couldn't believe what I heard him say. Sir, I wanna buy these shoes for my mama, please. Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes will make her smile, and I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus. Counted pennies for what seemed like years. Then the cashier said, son, there's not enough here. He searched his pockets frantically. Then he turned and he looked at me. He said, Mama made Christmas good in our house. Many years she just went without. Tell me, sir, what am I gonna do? Somehow I've gotta buy these pair of shoes. So I laid the money down, I just had to help him out. And never forget the look on his face. He said, Mama's gonna look so great. Sir, I wanna buy these shoes.
shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes will make her smile, and I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. I knew I caught a glimpse of heaven's love as he thanked me and ran out. I knew that God had sent that little boy to remind me what Christmas was all about. Sir, I want to buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes will make her smile. Want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus
Merry Christmas, everyone. What you got there, little buddy?
Legos!
Whoa!
I'm taking these to school so I can show my friends.
Yeah.
It's so exciting.
Wow, Legos. My goodness, you'll have fun at school. And would someone give this child a present? She is
yeah,
so excited.
Let's get
she's
that precious little girl that
oh,
special
so
gift.
Yeah.
Oh, there you
Allie.
Go,
Look
Allie.
Look at that.
Belle. She loves Belle.
Yes, that's beautiful.
Merry Christmas, honey.
Maggie, this one's for you. I know you have always wanted a locket with the picture of the kids in it, so I got you this. It's got Allie in her red Christmas dress. She looks so precious.
Oh, Allie, look.
And
you're
Nathan,
so beautiful.
He's in his suit over on
oh,
the porch next
so
to your
pretty.
Favorite
that
flowers.
Looks just like you.
Oh, this is the most beautiful locket.
Keep them close to your heart.
Oh, yes. Thank you. That is so meaningful to me, honey.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Merry Christmas,
I
sweetheart.
Love
I love you, too.
I have a gift for you, too, Maggie.
Mom, thank you. What a beautiful Christmas we're having.
Yeah.
Oh.
What you got there?
I remember
it's
this.
It's my shawl that I wore the day that I got married. And it just has so many precious memories to me.
Yes.
And Maggie has always admired it. I want to give it to her now. Nathan, will you help me with it?
Oh, of course. Thank you, Mom.
Thank you.
Thank you, Nathan, for helping. Oh, this is so beautiful, Mom.
There's one more present.
Another present. Everything is so beautiful. Mom, will you hold the locket for me?
Yes, I will.
Thank you. What'd you get, Nathan? The red shoes! Oh my goodness, they are
pretty.
So beautiful.
They were the prettiest ones they had.
I bet they were. You chose wonderful shoes, honey. Oh, they are absolutely gorgeous. Do you think I can put them on now?
Yeah.
I might need your help here.
Yeah, Ellie.
Oh, thank you both for helping. Oh, they're perfect.
Oh, yes.
Oh, beautiful red shoes.
Dancing
thank
shoes.
Thank you all for such beautiful yes. gifts.
Yes.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Christmas. Love you
Merry
all.
Merry Christmas.
There's
love
your
you.
Beautiful lock.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas. Love you.
Kate.
Shh.
Kate.
What's wrong with you, Robert? Be quiet. It's the middle of the night. You're going to wake the girls, too.
Kate, listen to me.
What's wrong with you?
Kate, listen to me. I didn't buy you or the girls anything for Christmas.
I didn't expect you to get me anything. But I figured you'd at least want to get your own children something for Christmas.
Kate, I don't know what to say, but I'm begging you. Please, just listen to me.
What?
Kate, I didn't buy you anything because I didn't know what to buy. I didn't know what to buy because I don't know you. I don't know you. You've all become strangers to me now.
What are you trying to say?
Kate, I was at the store. I had packages in my hand. I sat at the cash register, and it hit me. You and the girls, you're the greatest gift to me. But I don't treat you like a gift. Kate, the greatest gift I can give you is the gift of myself. Kate, I need to show you the love and the respect that you deserve. I need to be there to be a dad to the girls. They've had somebody in the house that's a father. They've called a father. Somebody that's a provider. But they haven't had a dad. They haven't had somebody that is there for them. I need to be a dad that can take them to the mall, that can take them to the movies, that can take them to the amusement park. I want to be there, be that dad to them. Somebody that is going to be there when they fail, when they're happy. Kate, I don't know how you feel, but I don't want us to end. I don't want this family to end. I love you, and I don't want to lose you.
Why the sudden change of heart?
Kate, tonight, I met a young boy, and he helped me see what was really important. Not the job, not the career, not the cars, not the home. You're the world to me. You really are. And the girls, you're the world to me. And I've messed up. I've been so focused on my career, so focused on other things, that I haven't been here for you. I haven't been here for the girls. I don't want to lose you, Kate. I love you with all my heart. And I don't want us to end.
What happened to you tonight?
Like I said, I met a young boy.
What about you? Anything happening in your heart? Either family represent where you've been. Maybe your marriage is in trouble today. Maybe you have a sick loved one today. As I said earlier, we lost a dear widow lady. Lisa and I have been through sickness over Christmas time. We've lost loved ones. You may not know this, but one of our choir members, she's going through chemo right now. You don't know, it's 309. We're not promised 310. Not promised tomorrow. What about right now? How's your heart? How's your heart in relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, more importantly? Have you taken Christ out of Christmas? Is Jesus on your list? I want to encourage you. Right here, right now, make sure Jesus is Lord of your life and make sure that He, the Christ, is in your Christmas. We have 7 days. Our Christmas, the Satterfield family, we're not celebrating Christmas yet. On the stage, in the drama presentation, they experienced Christmas already. We can experience Christmas in our heart each and every day. I like to have points in my message, and I'm going to give you 3 points today. Number one, admit that you're a sinner. My Bible says in Romans, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. None of us, our good works will not get us to heaven. We have to admit, I need somebody. His name is Jesus. The second point is believe. Hey, you're hearing all about believe right now. Believe. Get in the Christmas spirit. Santa Claus will come. Just believe. We've got some patches next door where you can have your picture with Santa Claus after the service, and they say, believe. Nay, nay, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you'll be saved. So that's point number two. Number one, admit that you're a sinner. Number two, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Number three, confess with your mouth that He is Lord and He is Savior, and invite Him into your heart right here and that right now. Number four, we are to live for Him to the very best of our ability for the rest of our life. That might be 3:12. It's 3:11 right now. What if you were taken right now? Would you be ready? I can tell you how to be ready. I just told you. Admit that you're a sinner. Invite Him into your heart. Ask Him to forgive you of your sins. Can we do that right now? Would you bow your head? Would you close your eyes? I'm not going to ask you to recite a prayer after me. Just kind of say it with me. Heavenly Father, I thank You that You sent Jesus Christ, Your only begotten Son, and He came down. He gave up all of heaven to come to this earth as a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes. He grew up to be a man and a great prophet and a great teacher, and He died on a cruel cross, and His blood and water came from His side. The blood represented the New Testament. The water was the Old Testament, where they had to wash the sacrifices. But there is a new blood, the only blood that can atone and save us and forgive us of our sins and cover our sins is the blood of Christ. Thank You for doing that. And then they laid Him in a tomb, but He is no longer there. On the third day, He arose and He walked among us, and over 500 witnesses saw Him. I believe that. And I believe that He's sitting, according to Scripture, at the right hand of the Father right now, waiting for the Father to say, Son, go get My children. I want to be that child that He comes after. When the trumpet sounds, I will be caught up with Him in the clouds. So I ask you to forgive Dallas. Would you say your name? 1, 2, 3. Okay, say your name on 3. 1, 2, 3. Dallas, forgive Dallas one more time. Come into my heart afresh and anew. May I live the rest of my days, however long that may be. You have the hairs on my head numbered, and You have the days of my life numbered. And I want to walk with You to the very best of my ability. And when my ability is not enough, You will provide the strength to carry on. Thank You, Jesus, for doing that. And all of God's people said, Amen.
Merry Christmas, girls.
Better get out.
Couldn't you wait for your dad and mom before you started opening presents?
No, Dad, it's too exciting. And you're too slow.
Well, I was sleeping in a little bit.
Sure. Anyways, Dad, are you staying the whole day?
I'm staying longer than that.
Hey, Tiger, how you holding up?
Okay. Is she already in heaven?
She is. As a matter of fact, she is singing and dancing with Jesus, playing with him just like she used to play with you when she was here on earth and not sick.
And she's all better?
She is. She's all better now. But everyone's home.
I was just a child when I first heard the story of how a babe was born in Bethlehem. But I never understood the true wonder of his glory until I put my life into his hands. And even though I'd never seen him, he lives inside my heart, I know. He's the miracle that came to us 2,000 years ago. God's own son sent down to earth for everyone, the light that shines for all the world to see. Oh, I believe.
I don't understand all the pain in life that happens. I know God never promised that I would, but I know he has a plan long before I had a problem, and I know that he will work it all for good. 'Cause even though I've never seen him, he lives inside my heart, I know. He's the miracle that came to earth 2,000 years ago. Oh, I believe in Christmas, because I believe in Jesus. I believe he's God's own son, sent down to earth for everyone, the light that shines for all the world to see. Oh, I believe. It's not a fairy tale that happened long ago. It's the story of a Savior who brought us heaven's favor. He's the Christmas gift for all the world to know. Oh, I believe in Christmas, because I believe in Jesus. I believe he's God's own son, sent down to earth for everyone, the light that shines for all. I believe.
It's Robert again. You know, God can use the smallest things to change our lives if we let him. I'm going to step out of my role as Robert, and I'm going to step into my who I am, which is Mark Abbott. During my devotional this morning in prayer, I feel the Lord really spoke to me, and he shared something with me that he wanted me to share with you. And it really has to do with this. Let's don't lose sight of what God wants to share with us. Let's don't lose sight of the important things. We can get caught up with Christmas. We can get caught up with productions. We can get caught up with all kinds of things, work, career, etc. But we lose sight. God is what's important. God is what matters. And there are things that are going to happen in our life that are going to try and distract us from seeing those little things. There's a book by C.S. Lewis called The Screwtape Letters. And in that book, one of the things that the little, if you know the story, the little demon tries to train, what happens is the demon tries to distract people from God. And we have a lot of distractions in this world, a lot of things. TV, internet, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, news, political things. I can go on and on. Another big distraction is right here. That's a big distraction. It could take you away from the important things. We're so focused looking down that we don't look up and see what God might be trying to share with us. Now I'm going to step back into the Robert role. So as Robert would say, I've learned a lot. I've learned that God can use small things to change our lives. He could use a school teacher, a child's laugh. He could use car brakes that need to be fixed. He could use a trip to the mountains to go cut down a Christmas tree. He could even use a pair of shoes. Some people, they won't get it. They think it's trivial. They think it's small. I used to think that way. But now, I believe, and I always will.
Come on, one more time. Would you give the Lord a clap offering? Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. I'm going to slip into the Pastor Dallas role. I don't know where I would be without Jesus and my wife. Let me just tell you. It's true. Thank the Lord he saved me and he sent along a great helpmate.
Amen.
Cannot thank you enough for attending again, taking your time to worship with us this afternoon. I pray that the Lord touched your life, ministered to you, and you leave encouraged. I want you to know, sometime we came in July of 2016, and shortly thereafter, this lady by the name of, let me read here, choir drama director, Laura Lindstrom, yeah, that was the one. She came and she had this dream immediately. I want to do Christmas shoes here as soon as we can. Well, this is as soon as we can. We found out, though, we're going to start a building fundraiser because we need to blow out this back wall so we can have some more room back there. But Laura Lindstrom, would you give her a hand for what she's done? We have some things for her. Come on down. Laura. Amen. Miss Laura, you can keep those this time. We gave them to her at 9:30 and then took them back. Also a great help was Judy Housley. We want to thank her for helping direct the choir, all the cues. Thank you, thank you, thank you. God bless you. Listen, there are so many to thank. Please read this, but Pastor Bill, would you please stand? He had everything to do with the tech, the lights and sound and everything. God bless you. What a great help. You're just going to have to read these. All of these were very important. All the AV, the choir, the cast, we couldn't have done it without them. About 50 or so involved in this. And, of course, you. You invited family and friends and made all this possible today. So God bless you and thank you for coming. There is a Santa Claus. Yes, it doesn't matter your age. We will allow you to go to Building C. It's to my left. When you leave, if you'll go to the building to your left, we have Santa Claus. We have some hot chocolate and some cookies. If you want to get sugared up, please feel free to go over there. Get your picture with Santa Claus. Anything else? Thank you. Thank you. And thank you for coming. Would you stand with me, please? Heavenly Father, we're so grateful. You have given us the talent, and we return that back to you. We thank you, Lord. We just want to be vessels. Thank you for working through us today. I just pray that your face would shine upon these precious people, that you would put a hedge of protection around them. The traveling time, people are flying and driving to various destinations to celebrate your birth, and we pray for protection. We pray that your face would shine upon them, that you would put that hedge of protection around them. We pray that we find favor with you. Lord, we celebrate you. We thank you for sending God. You sent your Son. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you. May you receive all the glory and all the honor. And as we leave this place, may you be honored and glorified in all that we say and do. And all of God's people said, amen and amen. Hallelujah. You may wonder what that clapping's all about. Our volunteers that helped build this building, they started that mess. And so when we say amen, we do the clap. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Merry Christmas. Have a happy new year. Thank you.